noi useremo solo piccola parte di questi appunti. Ok, adesso la registrazione è iniziata. Questa è la registrazione delle elezioni di 24 novembre, la prima parte. Su richiesta dei studenti cercheremo di tra poco di vedere la formula dei unioni di due, la formula della probabilità di unioni di due insiemi, e poi andiamo avanti con nostro piano principale, vedere che cosa significa. First we shall switch to English, of course, and we shall see what is the meaning of, in italiano, variabile aleatoria, in random variables. This is very important. But first, let me present what is done in our homepage. So I am going to our homepage to show you the situation for the moment. Therefore, please, okay, homepage and teaching. Math for neuroscience. So we had as lectures appunti richiami su analisi. Questo era una piccola introduzione in cui si faceva integrazione, avevamo un po' richiamo su numeri complessi, differenziabilità di una funzione di una variabile. E praticamente abbiamo detto che dobbiamo aggiungere qualcosa sulle equazioni ordinarie. Io adesso vi mostro l'intero file che ho preparato. Certamente in questo file l'unica cosa... Vedete il mio schermo?
Sì, sì.
Ok. Quindi qui per noi la cosa più importante... Most important thing shall be chapter 5, because this is the classification of different points around the systems 2x2. Of course, I can say I could clean chapter 4. This is not important. Critical part I am not interesting. Teorema di esistenza e unicità, chapter 3, is not important for us. Therefore, we shall concentrate only on chapter 4. But for completeness, I put these chapters, at least for students that want to know the mathematical base with rigorous proof. But again, for us, the most important thing shall be chapter 1, where we have returned to simple ordinary differential equation, and chapter 5, where we have practical concrete pictures. And so I am saying also this is linear algebra part. You can skip this part because we had very simple situation. Again, important chapters are 1 and 5. And then I started a little bit variabile, but essentially here we are following the book that I suggested. Or we can say that the most important thing from this file that I shall put immediately. So I am producing a file. Okay, this is okay. This is... Okay, and now I produce PDF file. Only for 2 minutes. Let us put in our homepage this file, and therefore you shall have really the basis for our ordinary differential equations part. This was your request. So this is our homepage, and we put the part of ordinary differential equation, appunti ODE. Questo, this is the first part. So let me make this link, make link, and I have to put the PDF file just now prepared Sorry for this small delay, but in this way we shall have for preparation our practical thing, I think everything. So we have Apunti, and we said this is the part connected math for neuroscience today. Yes, so we are putting in didactic annuale, lezione esercizi, and this is the file was on the E. Today is 24 on the G. Okay, save. Okay, and let us save all. We have yes, this file we shall put. Check if the home page is file save all. This is okay. Our home page is neuroscience. Let us put. And now we can see if everything is okay. So we have our. This was the home page. We shall make, you see, we have this big file with almost everything, especially we shall concentrate on chapter 5. If something as definition or property is needed, you can refer to, for example, sheet that we discussed at the beginning is here. So this part is done. Let me ask you if you have some questions for this thing that I put in the homepage. So you can take a look at it and say, okay, some here I cannot understand. Again, chapter five is what we need for our exam and our preparation. And let me turn to the presentation, stop sharing, and my next step shall be to answer to your question. So let us go to the whiteboard. Okay. And our usual work based on this and your question was one identity that we used. If you have for example A, it was probably, if we have U and V, two sets that belong to our algebra of omega, then we wanted to measure what will happen with U union with V. Of course, to have the probability of this set, we have to imagine, you can see this part. How is the resolution? Is it okay today? Can you see well?
Yes.
Okay, hopefully we have a good. So what we know, what we have to do, we know that when we have two disjoint sets, let's say two disjoint sets, for example W1 and W2, if these two sets are disjoint, then we know that probability of W1 union of W2 is probability of W1 plus probability of W2. This is what we know very well. I think you can understand that instead of two sets, if we have three sets, extend this formula. So we can have W1, W2, and W3 if we have this, let's put W3 intersected with W1 is empty set, and also W is the couple that remains. I think W2 and W3. You check any couple. W2 intersected with W3. If this is empty, then we can write even better formula. So you can write probability of W1 union W2 union W3 is exactly equal to probability, I shall write in this form, sum probability of WJ, J from 1 to 3. Of course, this property that is for three sets can be extended for more than three sets, let's say n sets. Now, what we have to do? Our purpose still is to represent this union as union of disjoint sets. So, what we can say, take the union. Of course, here we have, for example, this set that is U intersected with W. Now, what we can say, our U can be represented in such a form. Here we have the green set. And can you define this green set? If I have U, the green set is equal to what? I have to take my set U. This is U. And what I have to subtract from my set U in order to have the green set? Of course, I have to take this, let's call this intersection red one. So this is the red one. And we can say this is equal to U minus U intersected with W. Okay. To ask you if this relation is clear, the green one is the whole U minus the intersection. In the same way, we can take the blue one. What we can say about the blue one? Blue set how can be represented? As you can help me. How you can do this? For example,
it's B minus the intersection.
Perfect. So we the this is V minus, and here we put the red one. U intersected with the same U intersected with W. U, sorry, I am saying one thing and I am writing another. To keep this color representation, if you don't mind, I shall write also here. This is the green set is U minus subtract U intersected with V. Okay. Can you now see three disjoint sets? You can see the green one, the red one, and the blue one are three disjoint sets. Which are they? The green set we expressed, the blue one we expressed, and we simply can say what you can say about the green set and the red set. Are they disjoint? Of course, they are disjoint. What is the union of green and red? The union is the whole U. Let us write this equation. Our U is the set that is green set union with, now we can say union with U intersected with V. And moreover, let us write that these two sets are disjoint. As you can see, the green set, in the green set, you subtract U intersected with V. Therefore, points of U intersected with V are not in the green set. Now we can apply our probability relation that says probability of U equal to probability of green set plus probability of intersection. Remember that probability of intersection entered in our formula to ask me. Therefore, we can say probability of U is probability, now I show green set, to remind you that this is the green set, plus too many colors, okay, plus probability of U intersected with V. And you see, probability is okay. Now, I shall clean this part of the, you remember that W1, W2, W3 here are disjoint sets. We can do the same thing for V. What we have? Probability V, I shall write directly. This is probability of blue one, probability of blue set, plus the intersection, probability of U intersected with V. Finally, what we need is to understand that if we take the sum of all colors, we have three disjoint sets. As you can see, the green one, the red one, and the blue one, they are disjoint. If you take any couple of sets, they are disjoint. So intersection of red and green is empty. Intersection of blue and red is empty. Intersection of green and blue is also empty. Therefore, I can write my relation for union of all three sets gives us what is the union of green set plus blue set plus the red one. Of course, the union is U union with V, this set that we want to compute. Therefore, the last formula is P U union with V. The correct formula with disjoint sets is, take probability of green set plus, then we take probability of U intersected with V. And finally, we take probability of the blue set. And you see, now we have three important relations, and our conclusion is almost done. The only thing I want to ask you, if these relations are clear, or if you have some doubts. Because if we have all these relations, we can do something very simple. From here, the green is this probability minus this probability. I take the green set, substitute here. From this relation, the blue one is the difference between these. Take this relation and substitute and get the needed relation. But before doing this, let me ask you if these relations are clear. Okay, if you agree with these relations, we can write the final result. P of U union with V. We said I have to replace the green one with PU minus intersection. So I write P of U minus, and here we have the P of U intersected with V. So this guy, let me make a circle, is the green. I simply substitute the green one with the expression here. Then I continue to write plus. We have plus probability of U intersected with V, because this is written here. Plus, I have to add one, but the blue one is plus probability of V minus, and now we have probability of U intersected with V. So, as you can see, this is the blue one. I simply substitute the blue one in my relation. And now we can simplify. You see, minus P plus P minus P. The total sum is plus minus, they cancel and remains minus P. Therefore, from here we get the relation that asked me. Therefore, from here we get P. Can you see here? I hope you can see, because this is the important relation.
Yes.
Okay. P of U union with V shall be P of U plus P of V. P of U plus P of V. And then I have to make the balance between red ones. And you see, the red ones give me simply minus P of U intersected with V. So this is the correction that we have to add if the intersection is not empty. And this important relation, showing that in our union, we counted the red one two times there in the sum. You see, here in the sum, we counted two times this guy. And in order to have correct relation, from this, we have to subtract the intersection, and then the formula is correct due to this relation. Okay, let us see if you agree, if you have some questions. Of course, if you have, instead of two sets, let's say three sets, the situation is a little bit more complicated, but again, you can find there is a formula explaining what will happen with sum of three sets. But for the moment, I think to stop here and to use only this formula, because this was needed in our previous discussions connected with introduction to probability. Okay. So, if you have no more questions about the previous lectures, we can switch to random variables. This is our step. Again, we are following the book that I suggested. And first, let me clean the board. Okay. We said that our probability space was defined as omega, then we have algebra of subsets, and then we have this probability function that is the third element of our probability space. In order to define the random variables, we can say that in general, this is a function defined on our omega. So you have function that is defined and has some values in R. We can say that this function, before defining it, studying this, the this function, we can say that practically have this case, in the case of discrete probability space, our omega is followed by n elements. And in this, we took this algebra as the algebra of all possible subsets of our domain. And in our last lectures, we said that if omega is formed by x1, x2, xn elements, finite number of elements, we have to take one element, for example, xg, subset of one element, and say what is the probability that this set has. For here, we have kind of a real number, pj, that to each subset measures its probability. And we said that equidistributed probability space, they have the same value for any j. But this is not the real life. We can have situation in which when you take this one-dimensional set, then you have something that eventually will depend on this pj. So once we define this probabilities of sets of one element, then we say what is the relation. We know that this pj, they have to belong to the interval 0, 1. And moreover, the important relation is that when you take the sum of all probabilities, j from 1 to n, this total sum is 1. Here we had several examples, but when we say random variable, we said this is simply function that is defined on our set. So this is function defined on our sets. This is function from omega to R. One example, probably we can say some example. You can take x1, x2, xn to be, we can connect them with, we can connect with situation in which we have different towns. So we have, for example, let us take one example. And we have this x1, x2 are our different towns. X1 is one town, x2 is second town, x3 is our three towns. So we can have kind of supermarkets in X1, in X2, in X3. And for example, you can say that you can look for some kind of a good. If you look for some kind of a good, you can say, okay, in this case, I am looking for special good. For example, you are trying to find some shoes with special, how to say, property. Okay, what you can say? Probability that I can find x1, key of x1 that I find my shoes is 1/3. Probability that I shall find, this is in some sense given from the data. For example, the supermarkets in this town are more well equipped, and you have 1/3. Second town, you have probability is 1/6. Less supermarkets, less choice. What you can say about X3? If you have only three elements in our set omega, then you have to use this property that the sum of all three probabilities, Pj, shall be one. So what remains for Px3 is simply 1 minus 1/3 minus 1/6. So what is the result?
One.
Yes. So you see, without going directly to the third town, you can say that your data you have in hand data are sufficient to compute the last data. So you immediately can say, I shall go to the town X3. Okay, in this sense, you have your choice, but then the question is, okay, this is my probability. In any case, I can try to find shoes in one of these towns. But at some point, you are asking, how long the shoes I am buying shall be can be used? So when I have to throw away my shoes, how long I can use them? And then it comes out that you have something that is different. Again, like a function, for x1, you have one, this function is defined here, and his value is in R. For example, if you know that if you buy in x1, then you should have a very long period of using it. For example, the value at x1 is 10 years is too much, probably 2 years. Depends also on the person. This is something individual. For this is 5 years, for this is 7 years. So you have this random variable that is defined on your set omega, and therefore you call this special quantity, the how long you are using your shoes, depending on the market from on the town. Well, by you call this random variable. We shall find some other random variables, but the important thing is to know that this is something that is defined on your set of events, omega, and has values r. Actually, in this setting, we have to add discrete and continuous. What does it mean, continuous probabilities? I shall now replace the situation of discrete number of elements with another notion. Omega is an interval in this case, AB. So there are many situations in which you may look for something that has as probability space interval AB. Then, in order to define this set A of omega, we have to be very careful. But as first approximation of our algebra of sets, we can say that A omega is formed by finite union of disjoint intervals. For example, this is E1 union E2 union E3 and so on, union E kappa, where this EJ are intervals in our interval AB. But the important thing that they are disjoint. Remember that the fact that we can apply the formula for probability of disjoint unions is crucial. Exactly what we did to answer your question when we had W1, W2, W3. When take probability of union, if they are disjoint, they are disjoint. What does it mean? This means if you take any couple of sets, for example, E1 and E2, intersection is empty. E1 and E3, always the intersection is empty. For any couple, intersection empty, this means your sets are disjoint. And this is very useful set, because when take any set of this type, then you can define your probability. For example, one possibility to define your probability space is to take simply, we have to define P our interval alpha beta. Suppose we have one interval alpha beta that is inside our interval AB. This interval alpha beta is, of course, also can be considered as disjoint set. So we have to define what is the probability to be in this interval. And therefore, we have to define this. What possibility to define this depends. This shall be defined. If we define our probability for this interval, then we can define probability of all Ej, E1, and so on, intersected with E kappa in such a way. This is simply the sum of probabilities of Ej. How practically we can define, this is now the question, the right one disappeared here. Practically here, it is important to define this, this function, this probability interval. Actually here to work with continuous probabilities, we cannot more use representation of omega as finite number of events. We are obliged to work in interval. Our omega is simply the interval. Before introducing random variables, we have to say how is defined this probability. And then, of course, we have a good notion of probability of our. Of course, in our first setting, we used, in our discrete setting, we used p x1 plus p of x2 plus p of xn. Of course, this relation has no more meaning when we work on the interval. And therefore, in order to define an event of one element, this means we have here to have function. So we need here a function p of x. This function, you can say, okay, this function is defined from our interval a, b, and is in the interval 0, 1. But since we cannot write more px1, p, what is the notion that corresponds when you take, instead of sum, you have to take what is corresponding to the sum when you take the continuous version. Of course, this is the integral. You have to take some integral because you have sum of infinite number of such. So you replace this guy with the following one. Cancel this and you write integral from a to b, my px dx is equal 1. This is important property for our probability space because here we have kind of a function that is defined for any event that has one element. Therefore, this sometimes is called probability density. This is the density. And this quantity corresponds of our before what we asked, what we set the probability to have set of one element. Probability of xj. Now we have probability of x, not xj, because x varies in the whole interval rb. And instead of taking the sum, we take the integral. Of course, we know if the interval is given, and if the probability is given, that probability density is function p, then necessary condition is that this probability density is normalized, therefore the integral is 1. Let me make an important comparison. What is this p? we said this is probability over a set. Probably the better situation was to call this capital P. And this is our capital P. This capital P requires to take here a set. While this small p, this is the function that is defined for any real x. And we normalize our function with this condition. Of course, I say that this integral in the Riemann sense has to exist. Normally, for all our applications, this function p shall be this function and therefore integrable in any nice sense, for example, Riemann. And therefore, my first important point to underline is the fact that we use this probability density. To be more precise, let us make some example. Okay, let us take example. Before we go, we said that distributional probability means that p of x is independent of x. Here we put pxj, and we wrote equidistribution means that pxj is the same for all j. Since now our xj are continuous, this is all x, we say that this is one fixed constant, p0, that is independent of x. Let us see how you can define p0. So we have a and b are given. You know that your function that has to satisfy one is a constant. The question is, what is p0 such that one is satisfied? In order to find our constant p0 for equidistributed probability densities, equidistributed densities. This is important thing because almost everything that we did with dice in the previous lectures, this is for equidistributional densities. And as we said, in the case of biomedical models in neuroscience, you have to use non-constant probability densities. But in the case when it is constant, let us come. If I put this constant, I can put the constant P0 outside, and then I have the relation P0 integral from a to b of 1 dx is 1. What you can say about this integral? The integral is exactly the length of our interval. And therefore, from here I get p0 times b minus a is equal to 1. And from here you can find p0. From here, we find p0 is 1 over b minus 1. I have to change b minus 1. So this is the case of equidistributed probability densities. And before making the break, let me immediately now write what is our function px. Here I shall write simply that this is integral from alpha to beta p small px dx. This is by definition, in order to define your probability space for such disjoint intervals, you start with probability density, and using this probability, you can define this probability of the whole interval, this measure of this interval, as integral of our density from alpha to beta. Now I propose to make small break. You can think of after the break, we shall make some examples to make more clear probability density given how you compute this probability of different subsets. Okay, let us make, I shall stop the to record recording.